One could argue that WWE stars are grossly underpaid given the fact that they put their health and well-being on the line for over 200 days in a year. The performers don't get the time to heal, and their bodies often break down due to the amount of abuse and punishment they take on a consistent basis. While the WWE takes great pride in being able to put on multiple events in a week, it is the talent that busts their behinds to ensure the crowd goes home happy. No one has ever claimed that being a WWE superstar is easy. The workload only increases as you climb the ladder in the promotion, and once you reach the upper echelons and become one of the more popular stars, the fans yearn and demand to see you whenever WWE puts on a show. This often results in top WWE stars getting injured and having to sit on the sidelines for a considerable period of time. Injuries are a part of the wrestling business, something that WWE superstars sign up for while working for the company. My name is John, and in this video we take a look at 10 superstars that are currently injured and when they are expected to be back in a ring. When Fandango first hit the scene on the main roster, he was given a massive push by defeating Chris Jericho at WrestleMania 29 in his debut match. Following his feud with Jericho, he found himself unsuccessfully challenging for the Intercontinental title, but soon found himself meandering in the mid-card without being involved in any meaningful feuds. After being stuck in the rut for a considerable period of time, he was partnered with Tyler Breeze, and the duo soon became a comedy act on SmackDown Live. Breezango would be drafted to Raw during the Superstar Shakeup earlier this year, but Fandango suffered a left labrum tear in his shoulder, resulting in Breeze competing in NXT. The superstar is expected to be out of action for the remainder of the year and could return to in-ring competition by January of 2019. Goldust was one of the more outlandish characters WWE introduced in the mid-90s, and the superstar has been fairly successful in the company. Being the son of the legendary Dusty Rhodes was always going to put a lot of pressure and high expectations on the superstar, but he has always been able to make a mark for himself in the industry. Goldust has been competing in the business for nearly 3 decades, and his longevity also means that the star is prone to getting injured given the fact that he is approaching 50. Goldust recently underwent surgery on both of his knees and could be sidelined for the remainder of the year. The Golden Superstar wasn't involved in any major feud before the injury, and WWE could bring him back in time for the Royal Rumble in 2019. Given the age of Goldust, he is in the twilight of his career, and 2019 might be Goldust's final year in the WWE. When WWE decided to split American Alpha and bring Jason Jordan to Raw, the fans thought it would not end well for the star. Jordan was drafted to Raw from SmackDown Live because the WWE brass believed that the superstar could thrive as a single star, and for a while, Jordan did do well in singles competition. He was then inserted into a program with Seth Rollins, but before the WWE fans could find out how the angle would pan out, Jordan was pulled from Raw because of a neck injury and had to undergo surgery. While multiple reports have since surfaced about Jordan's return and how he could be back on WWE programming at any moment, a couple of days ago, a new report surfaced claiming that Jordan's neck injury was worse than what was earlier reported. Jordan has also started working with the production team backstage, and due to the conflicting nature of these reports, it still remains to be seen when Jordan will be brought back to programming. Sunil and Samir played an integral part in Jinder Mahal's ascension to the top of SmackDown Live, with the modern-day Maharaja winning the WWE title last year. While Mahal's push took everyone by surprise, Samir and Sunil were the unsung heroes, helping Mahal in getting more heat during his matches and were happy to sacrifice themselves for the cause. Samir Singh was injured earlier this year. Samir landed awkwardly on his leg, tearing his ACL in the process. While ACL injuries are generally considered to be one of the more serious injuries in sports, Samir has been training to get back inside a WWE ring. The general timeline to return from an ACL tear is anywhere between 8 to 12 months, and Samir can return to WWE programming by the end of 2018. Eric Rowan and Luke Harper caused chaos in the tag team division on SmackDown Live when the duo was paired together as the Bludgeon Brothers. Harper and Rowan were a part of the original Wyatt family stable and feuded with each other before both were taken off television. The Bludgeon Brothers won the SmackDown tag team titles before dropping them to the New Day on SmackDown Live last month. It was then reported that Rowan had injured his bicep during the Bludgeon Brothers match with the New Day at SummerSlam. Rowan is expected to be out of action for at least 4 to 6 months, and the superstar underwent surgery to repair his bicep last month. This would effectively rule Rowan out of the remainder of the year, and the bearded superstar could be back in action by early 2019. The masked superstar hasn't had the best of luck with injuries during his time with the WWE. While the original Sin Cara was prone to injuries in the company, Hunico, who was given the character of Sin Cara, hasn't done too badly since taking over the reins. Sin Cara was recently involved in a program with Andrade Cien Almas, and both the superstars faced each other at the Extreme Rules pay-per-view. In August, it was reported that Sin Cara had to undergo knee surgery, and he would be out of action for the next few months. Sin Cara suffered a knee injury last year, but was cleared to compete almost immediately. With the star now undergoing surgery, he's expected to remain on the sidelines for the remainder of the year, and could return to in-ring competition as early as 2019. Back in January, Tamina bravely worked the first ever all-women's Royal Rumble match while hurt, and after that event she had to undergo surgery to repair a torn rotator cuff. While the injury itself is known to keep performers on the shelf for about 6 months, Tamina wasn't featured heavily on WWE programming even before she got injured. Tamina has been in the WWE for nearly a decade, and while she is the daughter of a Hall of Famer, she has never been used properly on television. The superstar is already 40, and with WWE bringing in more talent from the independents, Tamina might never get to compete for the women's championship in WWE. However, she can play an important role in helping the women's division grow and is expected to return to WWE programming over the coming weeks. The former NXT champion had a phenomenal 2017 after winning the NXT title. Black looked better than ever, putting on some of the best matches in the history of the promotion. However, the former champion dropped the title to Tommaso Ciampa and was scheduled to take part in a triple threat match for the NXT title at TakeOver Brooklyn 4 against Ciampa and Gargano, but was unfortunately ruled out of the match with a minor groin injury which required surgery. The superstar wasn't expected to sit on the sidelines for a long time. However, during the recent set of NXT tapings, Black returned to NXT programming to find out who the attacker was. The storyline will continue during the next set of NXT tapings in October, and Black could return to in-ring competition by mid-October or November at the latest. It was the Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn show on SmackDown Live last year, but since the stars landed on Raw, they haven't had much success, and the duo once again got lost in the shuffle. While Owens and Zayn became two of the biggest heels on the blue brand, Owens was targeted by Braun Strowman, while Zayn had little to do on the red brand. Zayn was primarily used to put Bobby Lashley over as the new dominant force in the company, before Zayn decided to take some time off and take care of his injuries. Sami Zayn finally decided to undergo surgeries to repair both of his shoulders, something that he has been putting off for a while. Zayn underwent surgery to repair his torn rotator cuffs back in June, and was ruled out for the remainder of the year. Sami is likely to return to in-ring competition in early 2019, and in an interview given to WWE.com, Sami suggested that he would be back as a part of WrestleMania next year. The former Raw Women's Champion has had her work cut out for her this past year and is already a 5-time Women's Champion in the company. Bliss worked the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view, losing to Ronda Rousey, but has been pulled from live events and Raw with an arm injury. While WWE has attributed her match with Ronda Rousey to be the reason for Alexa suffering the injury, the superstar is currently experiencing numbness in her arm and is only currently cleared for minimal exertion, which could mean that Bliss will not return to in-ring competition over the next couple of weeks. While WWE replaced Bliss with Ember Moon for the Mixed Match Challenge, there is a feeling that Bliss could return if Strowman and Moon make it to the finals of the tournament. Bliss is still scheduled to face Trish Stratus at WWE Evolution, so the fans could see Alexa return to in-ring competition by mid-October.
Well, you're out walking the red carpet this weekend. We're on the road causing chaos in every town we hit, and if you can't be here...
And these are 10 injured WWE superstars and their expected return dates. I hope you're all having an amazing day. Thank you so much for watching Wrestling Hub, and I'll see you later with more videos.